In the previous movie, we finished rigging our character's left arm. In this movie, we're going to begin work on the hand. Start by opening the file Character Rigging, Part 28 Start, or by using your own file from the previous lesson. Individual FK and IK solutions would probably be overkill for a hand rig, especially considering how rarely you would need to plant the fingers themselves and move the rest of the hand or body around them. We could rig an FK control to each individual finger, as it would give us the ability to pose each finger exactly the way we want. However, that could quickly become a chore to work with, especially when you consider that fingers tend to move in compound motions. An IK solution can fix this, but its pose versatility would be a bit limited, since it would force all parts of the fingers to bend in the same direction. Instead, we're going to develop a hybrid FK attribute-driven hand. We'll use custom attributes to pre-animate the most common finger movements, like curling and scrunching, while including FK controls to allow small tweaks to individual finger positions when needed. First, let's unparent the hand geometry from the left arm group. Go to the top view and center the hand in the workspace. Create a set of 5 joints for the pointer finger. The first one should be placed within the palm like so. Then make sure to place the next 3 where the fingers naturally bend. Finally, place the end joint just outside the fingertip geometry. Rename them left pointer base result joint and then left pointer result joint 1 through 4. Now duplicate this joint chain for each of the other fingers. Rename them appropriately. You can do this quickly using the modify search and replace names command to replace the finger identifier each time. Note how there's an extra thumb joint. Don't delete it just yet. We'll explain why momentarily. Go to the front view and translate the joints up so they sit roughly in the middle of each finger. It'll take a little extra effort to get the thumb joints positioned correctly since it was modeled in its neutral position. This will help us later to get more realistic thumb motions. Next, create a new joint and point snap it to the arm's hand joint. Rename it left hand base result joint. Parent all the finger and thumb joints to this base joint. Select all the joints you created and open the orient joint options window. We want to orient the joints so that a positive Z rotation folds all the fingers inward to make a fist. Set the primary axis to X, secondary axis to Y, and secondary axis world orientation to negative Y. However, the thumb is presenting an interesting problem. Because it's not actually straight, a Z rotation bends it at a strange angle. This will make animating natural thumb motions difficult, since it will require rotations in 3 axes instead of 1, like the fingers. This shines a light on a more general complication with the thumb, which is that it has the ability to orbit, which the other fingers do not. To fix both these problems, we're going to introduce an extra joint to orient this more properly. duplicate the left thumb base result join, and delete its children. Rename this joint left thumb orbit result joint. Parent it to the thumb's base joint, then parent the existing left thumb 1 result joint to it. Now adjust the camera so you are looking straight down the thumb and use the rotate tool in object mode to rotate the thumb orient joint until the z-axis manipulator is perpendicular to the thumb. You'll need to rotate the other thumb joints so they fall back within the thumb geometry. After you've done that, be sure to freeze all their rotations. Now we can rotate the thumb result joints in just the z-axis and still achieve a natural-looking rotation. But we can also rotate the orbit joint in all three axes to simulate an orbit rotation. Notice how the last thumb joint isn't oriented parallel to the chain like the other finger joints? This is the reason we kept this extra joint. Now if you delete it, the last joint in the thumb chain is still parallel to the chain itself. We should also set all the rotation orders to ZYX so that the bend axis is always available to us. Now for each finger, select the faces corresponding to each joint and use the polygon menu's extract command to extract the matching geometry. Delete the extracted geometry's history and name it appropriately. Then parent the geometry to the appropriate joint. Make sure to move the pivot to the appropriate finger joint as well. Repeat this for the other fingers and thumb. We've included a scene file where this is done to make this easier for you. There's no real way to divide up the geometry of the palm, so we can either parent it to the hand base joint or skin it. We're going to skin it to the hand joints using a smooth bind with default settings, since that will help maintain a natural look for some of our thumb motions later. Now recall at the beginning of this movie, we stated how we would be controlling the fingers using an FK attribute hybrid approach. This will be hard to accomplish using only the current set of finger joints, since the two solutions would infringe on each other. Instead, let's create another layer of joints to manipulate. Duplicate the pointer finger result joint chain and rename each joint with an orient identifier. Delete the last joint in the chain and the duplicated geometry. Reparent the joints such that each result joint is directly under its corresponding orient joint, and each orient joint is under the preceding result joint. Also, rename the last joint in each finger chain with the orient identifier as well. You'll see why a little later. Repeat this for the other fingers and thumb. Now you can rotate each portion of each finger either by rotating the orient joint or the result joint directly under it. Finally, let's set up our FK controls. Like the other parts of the body, we don't want to control these result joints directly. We'd prefer to have a set of control joints layered on top instead. Duplicate the entire hand joint structure, rename the non-orient joints with FK control identifiers, and the hand base joint with just a control identifier. Don't worry about renaming the orient joints. We'll take care of them in an upcoming movie. For now, just delete the duplicated geometry. Unlike our arm and leg rigs, the hand doesn't use a blended IK-FK approach, so instead of connecting the FK hand to the result hand using a blend colors node, we'll just connect them directly with the connection editor. Set up connections between the rotate attributes of the FK joints to their respective result joints. We'll do these for the orient joints as well. However, because we'll want to use these to create stretchy fingers later, we'll also connect the translation of the second, third, and fourth orient joints. Now you can control the result joints with these control joints. The last thing we'll do is set up some control curves for them. Starting with the pointer finger, we'll create a NURB circle at the origin, then rename it and rotate it appropriately to the joint. Freeze its transformations and duplicate it so you have one control for each FK joint. Turn on Shapes in the Outliner and use the parent-r-s mel command to parent their shape node to each FK joint. Then use the control vertices to shape each circle to the contour of its finger section. Repeat this for all the fingers and thumb. We'll place these new FK joints in a layer named Hands FK Layer and set its color blue. We're done with our basic setup. In the next movie, we'll create a control for the fingers to make compound movements easier.